Okay, two examples on solving quadratic equations that are not factorable. And if you haven't seen the introduction video, the link will be in the description. You should really watch that first, and then these two are just extra practice. Alright, here we go. The first one is x squared minus 10x plus 4 is equal to 0. Remember step 1, we want to have 1x squared, which we do, right? And then plus a number times x. This time, the b value here is negative 10, so this is good. We don't want the 4, let's put the 4 to the other side, because 4 did not help us to factor this. So step 1, subtract 4 on both sides. And again, we just want to have the 1x squared, and then minus 10x, and leave a space here, and that's going to be 0 minus 4, which is negative 4. Then, remember, step 2, we have to get the magic number. And the formula for that is, let me write this down right here, we take 1 half times the coefficient of x, which is negative 10. So we multiply that by negative 10. And then we will have to square that. Half of negative 10 is negative 5. And then square that, we get 25. So this time we will have to add 25 here. And do the same right here. Add 25 here. Okay, after we add the 25, the magic number, this right here will help us to factor the left-hand side. And I'll show you the factoring for this real quick. We know x times x gives us x squared. And to get 25, I will use negative 5 and negative 5. And maybe you see already, yes, it's going to be this number all the time, right, when we're doing completing a square. And we can double check, x times negative 5 is negative 5x. And then this times that, again, negative 5x, so together we have negative 10x. So on the left hand side, the factoring is x minus 5 times x minus 5, so x minus 5 squared. And then that's equal to negative 4 plus 25, which is positive 21. Okay, to proceed, let's take the square root on both sides, and don't forget the plus or minus. On the left hand side, this and that can cancel. So we get x minus 5 equals plus or minus square root of 21. And finally, just add the 5 on both sides, cancel this, and we get x equals 5 plus or minus square root of 21. And we are done for that. All right, now for the second one, it's a little bit trickier because we have a 2 in front of the x squared. So we cannot do this yet, all right? We cannot find the magic number yet. We will have to first divide everybody by 2. Divide everybody by 2. We must have a 1 in front of the x squared in order for the steps to work. So after we do that, we will get x squared. And this right here, let's just put it as plus 3 over 2x. And this is negative 3, and then that's equal to 0 divided by 2, 0. Now we have a 1. Great. This time we have a fraction, but we'll just deal with it. We don't want the negative 3. Let's put it to the other side by adding 3 on both sides. Cancel this. So we get x squared plus 3 over 2x. Leave a space, and that's equal to 0 plus 3, which is just a 3. Now, we are going to figure out the magic number. Again, let's do it down right here. We take 1 half times this number, which is positive 3 over 2, and then squared. For the inside, 1 times 3 is 3, over 2 times 2, which is 4, and then squared. 3 over 4 squared, you just do 3 squared, which is 9, and then 4 squared, which is 16. So we come here, we add 9 over 16. Likewise, we do the same thing on the other side like that. Okay, on the left-hand side, for sure you can factor it. Better yet, you can even do the shortcut. Remember, it's going to be x, and this number will be from here. So if you do the shortcut, you get x, and then plus 3 over 4 squared. It does work, right? You can try the tic-tac-toe with fractions or just do a shortcut. Okay, on the right-hand side, let's go ahead and just do the fraction real quick. We have 3, which is the same as 3 over 1, plus 9 over 16. For this, let's multiply top and bottom by 16 so we can get a common denominator. 3 times 16 is 48, and then that's over 16, plus the top here is 9 over 16. 48 plus 9 is 57 over 16. Okay, so all this gives us 57 over 16. And then to continue, get the x by itself, we just take the square root here and the square root here, put a plus or minus, cancel this and that, and we will have the x plus 3 over 4 equals, okay, square root of the top, square root of the bottom. Square root of the bottom, square root of 16 is 4. So the bottom, no more square root. Square root of 57. If you break down 57, it's 3 times 19, that's the most we can do. Just leave it. So we have square root of 57, and then we have that plus or minus. Finally, bring this to the other side. So minus 3 over 4, minus 3 over 4. Cancel this. And ladies and gentlemen, x equals negative 3 over 4, plus or minus that. They have the same denominator. So let's put down negative 3 plus or minus like this, and then square root of 57 all over 4. And that will be the answer. Yeah, for that. So hopefully this right here helps, and you can check out how we can use the completing a square method to prove the quadratic formula right over there.